Yo, what's good everybody, man? We are back with another day at Dula, another day being charged up, and today we're gonna find out, can Kobe's best teammates win a ring in 2K24? So I built a team of the best players that Kobe has played with in his, almost 20 years in the NBA, which I'll go over in a second. Now, Kobe's been on the Lakers his entire career, so basically anyone that was a part of the Lakers is gonna be on this team, whether it be from 1996 to 2016 when he retired. So yeah, 20 years. So before we get into it, make sure you drop a like on the video, subscribe to the channel, and comment down below, who should I do next? I wanna do Kevin Durant, because he played with literally everyone under the sun besides LeBron at this point. If you wanna see that, let me know. Also, follow me on Instagram. We're trying to hit 5,000 followers on Instagram, so you can help me out a lot by clicking the follow. Let's get into it. Now, before I actually break down who I chose to be on the team, because some people might disagree with who I chose, let's go over all the players that Kobe has played with in his 20-year career. So let's start by the Kobe era, 2002, and that's, his prime, basically, with Shaq and all of them. So I took prime Shaq, 97 overall Shaq, 30 years old, and obviously Kobe's not on the team. He's the coach. But yeah, we have Shaq as our best player on the team, and I decided to take, we have Derek Fisher. He's been with him forever. Like, I think he won 5 rings in his career. It's not gonna be updated, but he won like 5 rings with Kobe, so definitely had to choose him. I chose Robert Horry, big shot Rob. He won the most rings out of all these players with 7. Which is crazy. And that's it. Rest of the team is trash, which is kind of crazy. Yeah, this team sucks. And then this year, 2K added the LeBron era, so we have a 2010 accurate roster of the Lakers. Well, accurate besides no Andrew Bynum. So the team is Kobe, Paul Gasol, Lamar Odom. So I decided to take Paul Gasol, Lamar Odom, and Ron Artest. You guys know Ron Artest hit one of the clutchest threes in the finals to help the Lakers win it. So yeah, he's a huge part. Then Lamar Odom, of course, he's a beast. He was a sixth man of this team. And then, of course, Paul Gasol, his right-hand man when he led the Lakers. So I definitely had to choose Paul Gasol, Lamar Odom. Matt Barnes only played here for a couple seasons. Again, Fisher has been with him this whole time. So, yeah, he's been crushing it. And that's it for that. And then I also added some few other players that I'll go over in a second. So here's the official team that I decided to make. It's Shaq and then Dwight Howard. He did play with Kobe for like one season or two seasons in 2013. So 2013 free agency, Kobe and the Lakers ended up getting Howard. The issue is Kobe was injured and Dwight Howard was injured this entire season. He played through a back injury, which definitely hurt him. So he's healthy in this video. And we got Paul Gasol. We have Gary Payton. From 2004, if you guys remember, Gary Payton and Karl Malone both came to chase a ring in their latter end of their career. It didn't work. My Detroit Pistons ended up beating them. So, makes me happy this fraud didn't end up winning a ring. Steve Nash, he joined in 2013 with Dwight Howard. But again, he was old. He was 39 years old in real life. And he was injured. So, it was a bad look. Eddie Jones was the first player that Kobe has played with back in 1996. If you go to the 98 Classic team for the Lakers, Eddie Jones is on this team, and he became a beast with the Heat. He ended up winning a ring with D-Wade. And then to top it off, we have Nick Young, which is I added just for fun, just for shits and giggles. Nick Young, 80 overall, back in 2015, 2016, Kobe's like last seasons. Decided why not. So this team on paper looks pretty good. We have a lot of good big guys, and Gasol, Howard, and Shaq. A decent, Gary Payton. But everyone is old. I chose their real ratings. I didn't put all of them in their prime. I didn't start them off as rookies. This is legit who he played with in their form. So the rotation looks like this. Is Gary, Eddie Jones, Ron Artest, Shaq, and Dwight. And then Paul Gasol is our sixth man with Steve Nash. So a good duo off the bench. You got Karl Malone too. Lamar Odom. This is a good team. But we're going to see, can we win a ring? How good of a season can we have? And we're doing this in the 0-2 Kobe era. So I got rid of Kobe from this era from the video. He's gone. The best players currently is Shaq, Tim Duncan, KG, T-Mac, Allen Iverson, Dirk Nowitzki, all that. So let's simulate to midseason and see how we stack up. This is going better than I expected, bro. 44-3 at All-Star break. But to be honest, we're in 0-3. Like, this type of basketball where big guys dominated, that's kind of what this league has been about at this time. So Shaq, Dwight, Paul Gasol, this is literally built for them. They're all doing well. Shaq's averaging 22-11 so far. Dwight with 14-10. Gasol off the bench averaging 13-8. Payton, 16, 9 assists, 2 steals still. Nash with 10-8. Eddie Jones with 17. Malone with 11. Everyone's doing amazing, bro. Nick Young probably not playing. He is. He's getting 7 points a game. Okay, probably Robert Horry's not playing. He's also getting... Oh, wait, no. Yeah, he's not playing. You can see the year, 0-1-0-2. This is not that season. Okay, Fisher's not playing at all. He got a rebound. He played in two games and got a rebound. So, because if you do the math, if you play in two games and you get one rebound in two games, you know, one divided by two is 0.5. So, with that being said, bro, hey, I feel like we could have an MVP on our team. So far, T-Mac is leading the league with 34 and 6-5. Iverson with 30. You know, I was watching a Lou William interview podcast with Podcast Pete, my guy Paul George. Insane, really good interview. But, like, it made me realize how insane Allen Iverson is. The fact that he carried this... He carried... Look at his team. Look at who Allen Iverson had to carry. Keith Van Horn, Eric Snow, Aaron McKee. Bro, his best teammate was Dikembe Mutombo, like, the year before. And he went to the finals with this team. Like, this guy is... He's up there in the GOAT talks. Real talk. I know it's crazy, but it's my opinion. So far, the next best team is the Pistons, who, hey, man, they might beat us in the finals. You never know. They got Big Ben Wallace. Who else do they have? Chauncey Billups, Rip Hamilton. Rasheed Wallace is not in the game for some reason. And same thing with Tayshaun Prince. They didn't put two key Pistons guys on this team. It's kind of weird. But let's finish out this season and hop into the good stuff. So KG wins MVP in 2003, which I believe is, I think he won it in real life in 03 as well. I'm pretty sure. I mean, I know my ball history. Bro, I have every old NBA 2K game in my setup. So if I might do a video, because he was the cover athlete of 2K. I might do a video of something with all the 2Ks. Yao Ming wins Rookie of the Year, averaging 15 and 12, two blocks. Paul Gasol, Sixth Man of the Year, yes sir, 13, 9 and 4. And Shaq or Dwight better be DPOY, it's Ben Wallace. God damn, 18 rebounds, three blocks a game. He earned it. I'm not gonna argue with that, bro. 18 rebounds a game is insane. I thought they fixed the stuff in the simulation where the stats are wild, but nah, 18 rebounds. What was his season high in a single game? It must have been like 100. It was 32. That has to be a record, right? Ricky Davis, most improved. Phil Jackson, coach of the year, 76-6 is our record. So, hey, we did that. All NBA first team, we have Shaq in the mix. Second team, none of our guys. Chris Webber, if you guys don't know, he's been added to the game this year. And then that's it. We don't have anyone else. All defensive first team, don't have anyone. Second team, we have Dwight. I'll take that. Now, I am curious about the Ben Wallace thing, bro. Most blocks in a game. I want to see if Ben Wallace has it. No, it's Elmore Smith. Elmo. Bro. No, Elmo was made before this. I was going to say. Imagine he made Elmo. That'd be kind of crazy. That'd be kind of hard. I made Elmo. Like, I am Elmo. It's like the kid version of I am Batman, you know, or Iron Man. What am I saying? I don't know. Most blocks in a playoff game goes to Hakeem with 10. Most blocks in a season goes to Wilt. No, that's... I thought he had 4,000 blocks. I was going to say. Let's fix that real quick. Sean Bradley with 288. But Ben Wallace is fourth with 222. And then most blocks in a career, Hakeem with 4,000. Okay. We'll see how that pans out. Now, we're first in the West. The New Jersey Nets are first in the East. And this Nets team is one of those teams that is just disgusting. And I mean it like in the weirdest way possible. It's just a random lineup. Jason Kidd, Kenyon Martin, Richard Jefferson, George Kittle's father. It's just a bunch of randomness. You know, you got Glenn Rice. You know, what's he doing? Age 35. You know, Jason Collins, as you guys know, he's gay. So Dikembe broke his left elbow. No. 6 to 8 weeks. You know what I'm saying? Aaron Williams, Rodney Rogers. No, I know about him. Brian Scalabrine. The lowest rated 2K player in NBA 2K history, back in like in 2K11, I think. Yeah, 73 this year though. He used to say, he has a saying, very popular, I'm sure you heard it, but he said he's closer to LeBron than a regular pedestrian is to him. I disagree. I think I could beat Scalabrine in a 1v1. As long as it's winner's ball and I have ball first, you're cooked. I'm gonna shoot over you every time, you know what I'm saying? And then Childish Chris is on this team as well. I know about him, but I don't think this team is that good. I mean, J Kidd, was bro cooking up this season? 24-10. That's really mid. But we're up against the 8 seed Sacramento Kings. We cannot take them lightly at all. Chris Webber, Peja's pissed. Mike Bibby's pissed. Doug Christie, everyone's pissed, bro. Why is Chris Webber the only happy one? Chris Webber must have done something to these guys. I don't know what happened, bro. Have y'all seen Mike Bibby today, bro? Bro, let me show y'all my baby today. If you haven't seen him. Damn. Wow. I gotta fix look it. At how big he is. Pause. But look at how like there's no way to say it without glazing. But yeah, he's huge, bro. Look at it. But the thing is though, is he on steroids? Because his face got fatter too, right? Because if you look at here, this is young Mike Bibby. He had a more chiseled face, right? And more, I would say, normal looking face, right? Is that fair to say? Like I would consider this normal, right? You look at him, normal. This just looks like he inflated his face with Botox. Like I'm not trying to judge at all. That's not what I'm trying to do, but like he looks a little off. It's like a little off-putting. Again, I mean this in like the best way possible. Take it for what as you will. But what happened to bro? Is it from steroids or what? Because that's a big ass face, bro. And it wasn't always like that. It was normal. You know what I'm saying? Is he on roids? It must be. Y'all let me know. If you guys know, you know, health, you let me know. But yeah, I mean, that's the team we're up against. I mean, we have a rookie, Gerald Wallace, or second year Gerald Wallace. He's a good fit for that team. But we're probably going to sweep him in round one. I expect nothing but greatness. And we end up beating them 4-1. So like Shaq was cooking up on Chris Webber. Actually, it was a good matchup. 23-10, 26-10. But we just had more pieces. You know, it doesn't matter their age. Ha. Carmelo. No, but I'm telling you, it doesn't matter if they're old or not. It's they're still gonna be productive. And now we're up against the Dallas Mavericks. So Dallas, of course, they actually had Steve Nash in real life, but I got rid of duplicates. So Dirk's best teammate is Michael Finley. Nick Van Exel, who played for the Lakers. I could have put him in the video because he did play with Kobe. But this team is a joke. Sean Bradley 7'6". You know, I'm 4'6". He's 3 feet above me. Hold on. Is this the Arab player? Tariq Abdul-Wahad. He's not Arabic, he's black, but with the Arab name, or just a Muslim name. He's from San Jose State, but what's his nationality? Bro, he looks like Dominican, I'm not gonna lie. He might be Nigerian. No, he's too late to be Nigerian. I would say he's from the Republic of Congo, or Kenya. He's from Kenya. But this should be an easy sweep, bro. Dirk is not gonna have enough to beat us, unfortunately. We're running through these teams, man. Eddie Jones dropped 28, so he's only 85 overall, but he's putting up the numbers for us. Dirk had 46. He's been averaging 30 this playoffs, but it's not enough. And now we have our first real challenge, the San Antonio Spurs. You know, with Tim Duncan, Tony Parker, David Robinson, Steven Jackson, Ginobili, Bruce Bowen. This is a good team. I just don't think they have enough to beat us. I don't think so. But let's see, game one, we beat them by 10, okay, everyone did average. Game two, we take them by 30, all right. Game three, we beat them by 10 again, and then they take a game. They actually beat us by 20. Parker and Duncan cooked up, and we beat them in five. We actually absolutely murdered them by 32 points, bro. Shaq had 27 and 4 blocks, and Tim Duncan couldn't do enough. He only took 9 shots. Steven Jackson is the one who sold it for him. 3-16 is wild. Like, who gave him the green light is my question. So we have a Lakers versus Magic finals, which is so odd. Actually, no, because Dwight was not drafted in real life yet. This was in 03, so a couple years before, or the year before. They're an 8 seed though. So an 8 seed, they won in 7 a couple times. And then, who's on their team? They got T-Mac. T-Mac could have been MVP. He put up 35 points in the regular season and didn't win MVP. But he put up 40 in the playoffs. They got Grant Hill, but Mike Miller tore his left Achilles out day to day. Jock Vaughn, the Brooklyn Nets coach, currently sprained his left foot. He's out. So it's up to T-Mac, Grant Hill, and Sean Kemp. Good luck. It's going to be a sweep. I'm going to hop in the game. They beat us? Hold on. They beat us by 20? T-Mac had 48. Let's not count them out just yet. Hold on. T-Mac might have to carry. Yeah, well, he definitely has to carry, but he might like actually win. 3-1 us, but that was a 1-point game. Yo, let's hop into this one. There should be no reason it's ever a close game against this team. We have too much firepower, and we're playing at home. Bro, look at the score. God dang. No way. It's like, I'm going to hop in. We're up by 50. What's been the biggest blowout win in a finals history? I feel like 50 has to be the record. No way a team's lost by more than 50. Bro, granted, we do have like, we'll check after the video, after this game, how many Hall of Famers we have. It's a lot. Grant Hill attacking. Okay. I mean, it's like that. It's like he has to let the cut the lead down to 50 or 48. Like Chris Paul. Steve Nash, though, Phoenix Toronto test. He's a good two-way player. Malone, he's good for morale, I guess. get the job done by any means necessary. Nick Young, we have a good system. The triangle offense. I feel like even if the team just had Karl Malone and Paul Gasol as our big guys, we would still crush it. We don't even have Shaq or Dwight in the game. And look at this, bro. Look at this defense. Ron Artest on the fast break. He's going all the way past the Steve Nash being unselfish. Now we got Grant Hill using the screen. Nice pass to DeClercq. DeClercq. Good finish. All right, bro. What are we doing at this point? We beat him by 52 points. That's insane. Shaq had 38. And the fact that he had no fouls is absurd, bro. We stayed out of foul trouble. No one got fouls, really. Nash had 21-9. Peyton had 18-10. Bro, I got to see our team stats after this game right here. Who would win Finals MVP? Shaq, right? Without a doubt, it's Shaq. Yeah, he averaged 22-11 and 2.6 blocks. So we did it very convincingly. But I do want to see some advanced stats. Where did our team rank in terms of everything? Three-pointers made, we were mid-tier. In terms of assists, number one by far. Rebounding, number one. Steals, number three. Blocks should be number one, yup. And fouls, bro, I don't know how this team committed the least amount of fouls. That's very surprising. So let's see who retires. We have Karl Malone retiring. I'm going to bring him out of retirement one last ride. And that's it. Okay. We'll try to run it back. We'll just see. So team is still the same. Overalls should be going down for everyone because they're getting older besides Dwight Howard. So, I mean, now LeBron's in the league. The question is, where did LeBron James end up? He ended up in Portland. So he's got to carry Portland. Jordan's still in the league with the Wizards. And what about D-Wade and them? It don't really matter. And we come back next season with a total of 74 wins. Jason Kidd winning MVP, bro. More power to him. He's also the cover of NBA Live. NBA Live was really on top once upon a time. If y'all want to see an NBA Live simulation, I'm down to do that. LeBron James, rookie of the year, of course. Nash is our sixth man now, averaging 11-9. You know who he looks like? He looks like that one actor from Night of the Museum. What's his freaking name, bro? Steve, growing up as a kid, I was always like, yo, that's the guy from Nights in the Museum. Nights in the Museum 2. I mean, he's the same actor in all three of them. I think it was three of them. But he looks just like him, bro. If you ever watch that movie, bro, it's where the museum turns into a real, like, the dinosaurs is not, like, fictional. It's like, they become, it's a museum that, but, okay. How do I want to, it's like the animals come to life. It's such a banger of a movie. If you watch it, you know what I'm talking about. Ben Wallace, Defensive Player of the Year. Tony Parker, Most Improved. Okay, okay, okay. Hey, let's go back to back. That's all I care about. Are we healthy? Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't get any real injuries throughout this video. I feel like now, because I said that, we're going to get injured in the playoffs. Just watch. Nope, so far we're still healthy. Okay, round two, we sweep that. Okay, we're up against the Kings. Still healthy. So we beat them. And we're up against the Pistons. And the Pistons are also healthy. So we have the Defensive Player of the Year against us. Should be an easy sweep. 3-1. Whoa, wait a minute. 3-2. And they're playing at home. So they might actually make it a game 7. And it is 2004. So just like in real life, we might see. Nope. That would have been cool though. God, man. We ended up winning. I'm happy to win. Right? Shaq, MVP. Let's three-peat now. Well, Karl Malone retires. Steve Nash, we could bring him back for a season, but this guy's, he's done. And that's it. Next season, Parker wins MVP. Paul Gasol is back to sixth man of the year. And Shaq is, there we go. That's the injury I was waiting for. Torn right calf muscle. He's out for 8 weeks, basically 2 months. So Nash is dealing with twisted left ankle. All right, now the real challenge begins. And honestly, some of our teammates left us. But if we can three-peat without Kobe, that will be very interesting. Round two, we lost. We lost. That's a wrap. I mean, we didn't have Shaq. Some of our guys left us. We're all old. I'm not surprised. T-Mac gets his. Happy for him. And on that note, we'll end it there. Steve Nash retires at the age of 39 years old. And yes, Kobe's best teammates can win a ring back-to-back times. They had like 70 win seasons. It was a W. So comment down below, who do you want to see next? And their teammates try to go for a ring. I'll catch you guys tomorrow, man. Peace.